Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Now we are back live again with the new topic. And this new topic will cover the implementation of frequency shift keying in the first lab. And then second lab, we will do the binary phase shift keying. First of all, I will discuss the background of the frequency phase shift keying. Frequency phase shift keying, or the frequency shift keying, sorry, which in terms called FSK, is a frequency modulation scheme in which digital information is transmitted through discrete frequency changes of a carrier wave. For instance, if you have got a carrier wave and that carrier wave has got a continuous frequency, then that particular continuous frequency will be changed as per the transmitted or the baseband signal. That is the main theme of the frequency phase shift keying. For instance, you can see that we have got data over here. That data has got certain pulses with respect to the time, which means that data represents highs and lows. This can be represented by binary one, and this can be represented by the binary zero. The low pulse, or the pulse which has got no energy associated with it, or the 0 volt associated with it, can be termed as the zero in terms of binary. And the pulse, which represents the maximum voltage of the system, for instance, that can be 5 volts or 10 volts. And generally speaking, we affix 5 volts with that particular system. The 5 volt system, the high voltage that can be shown in that particular pulse, we can take that as a binary 1. So we have got 1 over here, then zeros, 2 zeros as per the time, then 2 ones, then 0. So you can see that we have got a data with variables ones and zeros. That data can be modulated by a continuous wave. Since previously we have seen that frequency can be modulated, frequency can be changed. So you can see a zero is modeled by the low frequency, and the binary one is modeled by the high frequency. The high frequency where the binary one is modeled is called Mark frequency, and the zero of that particular data pulse where the zero is being modeled, that is being termed as the space frequency. These are the two terms. These are the two things which make FSK. So which is basically a modulation scheme which is used to send digital information between digital equipment such as computers, teleprinters, or some other computing equipments. So the data is basically being transmitted by a shifting of the frequency of a continuous carrier, which I was talking. The carrier is continuous, and that the shifting being taken place in the frequency domain, or the frequency is being shifted in a constant manner. Either for representing zero, we have got a definite low frequency, and for representing the binary one, we have got definite high frequency, which is can be marked as Mark frequency and the space frequency. By convention, Mark corresponds to the higher body frequency and the vice versa. So what we will do, if we will use this NI-LVS2 powers board for the FSK modulation. Now we will start the NI-LVS board, the lab of this on this NI-LVS board. So basically, this is NI-LVS soft panel where we can see different options available, and we can control this NI-LVS, the hard board, the hardware, with this soft panel. So we'll be using a function generator, oscilloscope, and the variable power supply. I will double click, the function generator will open. This is how the function generator, oscilloscope. I'll share the screen so that you can also look these different panels. Okay, so let me share the screen as well. This is the variable power supply. This is how the variable power supply looks like. We have got positive and negative. And if we want to change, first press the run button. And you can see when I change, the value of the positive voltages changes. Second, we have got, secondly, we have got the oscilloscope. This is the oscilloscope. which is being presented over here. We have got very same knobs and controls as we have got in the hardware section. So now we're going back to the topic again and see how we can learn and how we can see different aspect of this frequency phase shift, frequency shift. Okay, now, first of all, we need to adjust the function generator use specification. And where I can find the function generator, let me share the screen of the function generator for you. Instrument launcher function generator. And in this function generator, okay, there is the function generator. You can see the function generator. The function generator must be modeled, which should have wave as a sine wave. Sine wave, yes, we have got two waves. One is sine, the other is triangle, the third one is square. So we should select the sine wave first. The frequency must be 10 kilohertz. So 10 kilohertz means we should have got 1000 and then 10,000. This is 10 kilohertz. Amplitude is 4 volt. So this is 1 volt. Sorry. Mistake should be. This modulation type must be FM. The modulation type is FM. And this is how we can connect the. This is how we can set up the function generator. Okay. Now we will connect the diagram. As per the diagram, the master signal. We have got the master signal over here. This is the master signal. The other one we will be using is a sequence generator, which is over here. The sequence generator. Sequence generator has got two soft dip switches. If you have got, you can see over here, 00 represents non-return to zero. The 0110 and 11 are the different line coding schemes that we can utilize. So for instance, this is 00. And then if you select the dip switch or the slider dip switch on the downward side, you can say it's 11 now. So dip switches can select different line coding schemes. So basically, to set up the basic FSK signal, we'll be utilizing first the master signal, and we will use this 2 kilohertz digital sine wave, 2 kilohertz digital wave, and we will use this 2 kilohertz digital wave to clock the sequence. And this, the line code and the sync pulse will be used, and then this sync pulse will be observed at channel zero, and the line code output will be utilized as the function generator's input. Okay, this is the function generator over here. The function generator's inputs to the voltage control oscillator's input. So we will be giving line codes input to the VCO in, so that the VCO can oscillate at the frequency being generated, or the voltage level, not particularly the frequency, but the voltage level from this line code. The VCO. And then this function out will be observed at channel one. Okay, now hardwiring the lab. First of all, as per our discussion, we will be using the master signal of 2 kilohertz digital wave. Okay, and this master will be used as the clock frequency. And then we will be using the sync pulse from this sequence generator. See the sync pulse, the output of this sync will be used to the frequency generator. So then this is how we plug in. We have got 3 leads over here. The other lead is over here. This is how we plugged in. This is the channel zero. Okay, now these are the clips, and then this will be going into the function generator.
sink. And then the ground over here. Okay, see, I've connected. Okay, one thing that I've been taking, not properly been done. Okay, now insert it properly. Line code will be taken as the voltage control oscillator's input, and then it is then dusted. The line code, the output of the line code will also be observed at channel zero. The channel zero is here. Channel zero. Sorry for the shaky video because I'm handling the camera by myself. Okay. Line code. And then the ground. There are multiple grounds available. Ground over here. The line code being observed at channel zero. And at channel one, we'll be observing the function out. This is the channel one. Function out. The prettiest part is this, to find the ground. Okay. See, now the wire has been plugged. Okay, first we will launch the DATEX soft front panel SFP and check that you have soft control over the DATEX. So you can easily locate some soft buttons on the Imona DATEX board. Over here we have got power button. If you turn on, the green LED will turn on, and then another main power switch board is over here. This is the main power switch board. You can easily see this. This is the main power switch board. This will turn off the Imona DATEX board, and this will turn on the Imona DATEX board. So this is the main power board, and this is the soft control board. Okay, these are the two switches. And if when we turn on the power or programming mode, this will turn on the LEDs and these three LEDs over here. Okay. Now, since we have got the soft control over the Imona DATEX board, we will launch and the soft panels. Generator module and set the soft switch or the two dip switches to the 0-0 position. This is, as previously I've stated, this is 1-1 and this is 0-0. I've turned the soft dip switches to 0-0, and then I have to run the NI Elvis scope board or the oscilloscope. Activate scopes channel 1. Now the channel one is activated. By clicking this enable button, you can enable or disable the given channel or the stated channel. Activate scopes channel one input to observe sequence generator module's output and the FSK signal out of the VCO, since we are not getting any output because we haven't connected the board yet. So first the board has to be connected, and then the signal has to be given as the input. So when we turn on the switch, the board is now activated. Okay, so we have to run. Now you can see, so you have to press the run button over here as well. So you can see the output of the sequence generator module, the FSK signal out of the VCO. So ensure that the scope's time base is at 500 microseconds per division. This is the scope's time per division, 500 microseconds per division position. Okay, this is the part one of the lab that we have performed. Now moving to the part two or the part B is the demodulating, or how to demodulate an FSK signal using filtering and an envelope detector. As FSK is really just a frequency modulated with a digital message instead of speech or music, it can be recovered using any of the FM demodulation schemes. However, the FSK signal switches back and forth between just two frequencies, we can use a method of demodulating it that cannot be used to demodulate speech input FM signals. So the next part of the experiment is to demodulate an FSK signal, and then we will hardwire as per the experimentation. Okay, for this we have previously utilized the master signal sequence generator. Okay, first turn off the switch. So you turn off the board. Over here you can see the board is being turned off. So we have utilized master signal sequence generator and the function generator. Now for the demodulation, we'll be using tunable LPF low pass filter, and in utility section we'll be using diode part or diodes part, and we will be observing it at channel number one. So okay, now hard wiring it. First of all, using the function out. First of all, using the function out over here, plugging in function out to the tunable LPF. Okay, see, function out to the tunable LPF, and then from tunable LPF, we have got another port of output. From this output, we have to connect channel number one. This is our channel number one. The channel number one. Okay, here we go. The channel number one when connected, the function out. Okay, one more thing. I have to use the smallest part or the smallest wire. I'm just getting. Okay, now I've got the smallest wire. Okay, from the function out connect this diode filter. Okay, and then you see this function out over here. So again, at channel zero, we are observing the line port at channel zero. At channel one, we'll be observing the output of the data export. Good. Now again, turn. You can easily look the diagrams over here. We have connected this diode to the channel out over here, and from in sections we have connected the function out, and then VCO. This is as per the input. This is for the output. We have used the tunable LPF, and then tunable LPF, we have got gain and center frequency or the corner frequency. We will adjust this corner frequency and we will look at the results. Okay, now we will back. We will turn on the function generator first. This is the function generator over here. First, we have done all the settings before, and then we need to run the function generator. After clicking the run button, you can easily see stop. Okay, this is the function generator is on the stop condition. After doing 10 kilohertz over here, sine wave 4 volt peak to peak frequency modulation type FM or the modulation type FM, click on the run button. When this run button has been clicked, you can easily see. Let me share you the screen of the oscilloscope. Where is the oscilloscope over here? Okay, now you can easily see the output and the input both enabled. Now this is the input. This is the input, and this is the output of the tunable LPF. The blue wave. The green one, this green one is the output of the line port, and I will disable this green one. This blue one is the output of the, what you can say, the output of the tunable LPF. Turn the gain, turn, you can easily see on the video. I'm moving the gain, the one at the LPF over here. I'm on the LPF, tunable LPF side. I've got two knobs, the corner frequency knob, and below the corner frequency knob, I've got the gain knob. Okay, I will let you know. See over here, we have got two knobs. One is center frequency knob, the other one is the gain knob. Sorry, corner frequency knob, corner frequency, and the gain knob. turn this gain knob to this position. Okay, so that the gain is maximum. You will see the output. I'm changing the gain. So you can see the output is decreasing. And if I change the gain to the right side, maximum side, you can easily see that, you can easily observe the waveform. Okay, now slowly tune this corner frequency. Okay, I'm tuning this corner frequency very slowly to the left hand side. You can see the output. I've got the output over here. See, this is the mark frequency and the space frequency. And if I open this, you can easily model the both the frequencies. You can easily see the both the frequencies. Now we will move forward to part B. And this part C, I'll modify the setup and I will modify the setup such so that you will see the output from the RC, the resistance and capacitance low pass filter on the channel one. So what I'm doing now, I'm moving the output to this position, RC LPF. Now on the channel one, I'm observing the RC LPF. Where's the oscilloscope? So see, you can now, if I change the gain, sorry, corner frequency over here, I will stop this. You can see I'm slowly changing so that the mark frequency or the maximum frequencies are all zeros, approximately zero. This is a very tricky part of this experiment to model or to change the FC, because slight changes can occur can result in huge changes. Okay, the part C is basically restoring the recovered. Part C is basically restoring the recovered data using comparator. Now we have got the comparator over here, and I will use the comparator signal again. Modify the diagram. I will use the comparator, restoring the recovered data using a comparator. And then all the comparator, I will use this variable DC supply, positive side. And I will use this comparator. Okay. For the reference point, I will use the DC signal to reference, switch off the variable DC supply, positive side. Okay. And the other part of the comparator's input is from this RPF. From this RPF, take the input to another input of the comparator, and on the channel one are the output of the comparator. We will observe the output of the comparator on channel one. Switch on. For this, first we have to see, we have to set the variable power supply. I'll use this variable power supply, and I'll set this variable power supply to such that we can have the modulated signal. Okay. Now again, turning back to the scope, I will turn back to the scope again. The system is on, and I will show you on the scope first how the output is currently looking like. Oscilloscope, here we go, the oscilloscope. This is how the output is being looking like. Now I will slowly turn the variable power supply model button. I will show you the variable power supply. Okay. This is the variable power supply positive side. It is hanging right now. Let me restart the variable power supply soft button because it's currently hanging. Okay, this is the variable power supply. So I'll click on the run button. So you can see the output is changing. I will slowly change the output so that I'll get an output on the oscilloscope. Okay, so I'll show you how the output of the oscilloscope is looking like, and you will observe the output. I'll change the, what you can say, variable power supply positive button. Okay, over here you can easily see the oscilloscope. Now I'll see what you can say. Let me move away. Now I'll see, I will move the variable power supply, and you can see how we are getting some results now. Okay, we are getting some results now. Set the variable power supply's positive output to 0 volt, and then modify the setup. Compare the signals. If they are not the same, adjust the variable power supply's positive output soft voltage control until they are, if they are visible. These require adjustment to the reference voltages close to zero. So let me show you the oscilloscope first. This is the oscilloscope. This is the oscilloscope. And now I'm adjusting the variable power supply button. You can easily observe the changes. I have to make sure the correct change, the correct signal. Easily now you can see almost the signal is same. There is only a single spike. So almost there is a single spike. It's 274.54 millivolts approximately. Something around there. So this is how you can demodulate the FSK signal. So using a monitor text board. I hope you have enjoyed the lab. Please do let me know if you have got further queries. So thank you. Thank you for watching. And please do like and share and recommend my videos to others. Thank you.